Hi there, it's Brittany from Fine Tune Pilates. Today I have a full body Pilates workout for you to really get the heart rate going. It's a really intense core workout and to boost that metabolism, great for the holiday season. So let's get started. All you need is your mat today and we'll make our way all the way down onto our back to start. So rolling all the way down. Gonna start with a simple ab curl. So taking your hands behind your head, feet hip distance apart, tailbone down. Take a deep inhale, and then on your exhale, start to curl yourself up. Inhale back down, and exhale curling up, moving with that breath. Inhale down, exhale, and you should really hear yourself breathe, really pressing the air out from the belly. Helps to contract those ab muscles and get a little bit deeper. So warming up here, let's go for five more. Make sure that you're not lifting with your neck and it's coming from the abs. So your tailbone is heavy, your rib cage is down, and the head is just resting in the hands. And let's go for two more. We're gonna hold at the end of that second. Two. And last one, holding there, neck is relaxed. I want you to start to draw figure eights. So if it helps, think about, imagine just walking those elbows forward, trying to reach the elbows forward. And really just drawing figure eights on the shoulder blades. So while we're doing this, we're keeping our hips really still. They're not wiggling, just the elbows are. And keep breathing here. Deep inhale. Long exhale. Keep those knees pointed straight up towards the ceiling and keep lifted in your curl. Don't let it fall down. So really keeping strong through the core. And let's reverse the circles. So imagine backstroking with the elbows. Big backstroke. Keep those knees pointed straight up. Hips are not rocking. We're waking up those tiny little oblique muscles right around the rib cage, definitely the six-pack muscles. And let's go for three. And two. Backstroke and one. Good. Rest it all the way down. Very nice. Take your legs long now. Reach those legs away from you. Take a deep inhale. And on your exhale, curling back up. Inhale back down. So we really want to start to flatten out the belly. Feel a nice, strong contraction through the abs. And exhale. Make sure that you're not just moving the neck here. Keep the chin tucked in and curl your shoulder blades off the mat. And let's go for four. And three. And two, keep reaching those toes away. We're gonna hold at the top. And one, start to draw those little figure eights again. So imagine walking your elbows through mud. You're really finding that resistance, crawling, crawling, crawling forward. And then you really start to feel those top abdominals. Reach the toes away. Make sure the hips aren't rocking back and forth. Lots to think about in this exercise, but it's really, really great for toning. And let's go for four, and three, and two, and one. Don't forget the other side, and all the way back down. Very nice. Relax your arms down now, relax your upper body, and step your feet back into that hip distance. On your next exhale, we're gonna start to lift both legs into tabletop. So knees stop right over the hips. And then inhale back down with control. Exhale, start to lift those legs up into tabletop. And inhale back down. Good. So this video is suitable for beginners or more advanced. There are some challenging moves, and I'll give you some variations to make it easier or harder. So this exercise, simple hip folds, but try to keep your rib cage down, your tailbone heavy, and your back pretty much relaxed. The abs are doing all of the work. That's when it becomes really difficult, really strong through the core. Inhale down, And exhale, lift those legs using the core. Ooh, I can definitely feel this in my top two abdominals, right down to those bottom two. And let's go for three. Keeping your back in neutral, rib cage relaxed. Two, almost there. And last one, hold in tabletop. Good, take your hands behind your head, interlacing your fingers, elbows wide. On your exhale, curl up through center. This time I want you to take your left leg long and exhale, twist the right. Inhale back in, exhale opposite direction. Inhale and exhale. Good. So this is one of the most classic exercises in Pilates and classic ab exercises. It really helps to contract the core and get that heart rate going, which always helps the metabolism. Good. So trying to keep those hips still again. Your option here, you can take the leg nice and high so that you're not feeling any strain in the back. You should never feel strain in the back, only in the abs. So keep going. And exhale. Reach those toes away from you, really long. Exhaling each time you twist, almost there. And you don't want to pull the elbow towards the knee. You want to reach the chest past your leg. So think about reaching that chest, elbows stay wide, so we're not pulling on the neck. Almost there, let's go for four. Make sure those hips stay still. Three. And two. And one, back to center. Go back to your starting side and hold. Exhale, start to curl a little bit deeper. Reach your chest over that leg. Inhale, back down. Exhale, reach, deepening your curl. Drop the rib cage. Inhale, back down. Two more, exhale, deepen that curl. Ooh, this is really intense. And last one, exhale, deepen. And back down, drop your head if you need to, or let's go. Exhale, twist to the other side, and then exhale. See how my ribs are really dropping, and then inhale, release. Reaching that chest past the leg. Inhale, release. Let's go for two. Not pulling on the neck, use those abs. Really lift, and one, all the way back down. Hug your knees in towards your chest for a quick break. Rock from side to side. Good. When you're ready, coming back into center, and let's take the legs into tabletop again. Knees right over the hips. If this is not comfortable for you, place your feet down, don't worry about it, okay? If not, add on by lifting the legs into tabletop. Take the hands behind the head one more time here. On your exhale, let's curl up and hold. Good. And we're gonna start to draw those figure eights again. So start to walk your elbows forward. Wiggling those forward. Imagine you're kayaking. That's a good example of this. So really starting to wiggle those elbows out. Keeping your hips still. So remember, if you need to put your feet down, don't worry about it. Good. Keep going. Long inhales, long exhales. You should really start to feel this right across the torso, sort of that corset area. And make sure you're not just moving your neck. Feel one shoulder blade lift and then the other down. And let's reverse, so backstroke now, or that kayaking move. Keeping those hips from wiggling, lots of work here. And let's go for five. And four, big backstroke. And three. And two. And one, good, all the way back down. Hug those knees in, really nice. Good, take your legs long this time, stretching them right up, and then reach your arms back. Take a nice big stretch, inhale. And then exhale, let the rib cage come back to the mat. From here, we're gonna inhale the fingertips up towards the ceiling. Exhale, start to curl yourself up and over for a roll up. Reach for the toes. Inhale, stack the spine back up. And then exhale, tuck your tail under. Scoop it around the back. Scoop the belly. Lowering all the way down. Very nice. Inhale, fingertips come up. Exhale. exhale, start to curl. Reach, reach, reach for those toes. Keep the feet down and reach for it. Very nice. Inhale, stack it back up. Exhale, tuck your tail under, round your back. Keep those shoulders down and slowly lower yourself back down to the floor. One roll up is like 6 ab curls. It's really challenging. You're reaching for those toes. If you're having trouble with this, don't worry. You're not alone. I see it every day where people really struggle with these. Bend the knees if you need to make it a little bit easier. Lowering all the way down. Woo! Can really feel those abs. Let's go for 2 more. Exhale, reach for those toes. Keep the heels down. That's the hard part. Inhale, stack it back up, nice tall spine, and exhale, round, scooping the tail under, hollow out the belly. Good. Last time, let's inhale the fingertips up. Exhale, start to round, reach for those toes, keep the heels down, you can do it. And reach forward, stack the spine back up. This time, I want you to exhale, tuck your tail under, so scoop your tailbone down, round your back. Reach the fingertips forward and just a half roll back. So wherever's comfortable, where you can hold. Good. I want you to take your hands behind your head. This might be enough for you. If not, we're gonna start to add on and we're gonna do those little kayaking moves. So wiggling your elbows forward. Trust me, this is very hard. Keep your tailbone tucked under, pubic bone squeezing to navel. So really pull it in towards your belly button. And if you need to, again, you can bend your knees. That might take a little bit out of the back and put it into the core. And let's reverse here. So nice big backstroke. This is not easy. I'm shaking. I don't know if you can see that. And let's go for 4. And 3. And 2. Woo. And 1. Good. All the way back up. Reach. And lengthen over the legs. Beautiful work. That is not easy. Roll yourself back. Good. Let's move on to all 4s now. So lining up your shoulders, elbows, and wrists here. Knees right under your hips. Spine is long, so we're not slouching or rounding. Nice long spine. Reach your right arm forward. Slide your left leg back. On your next exhale, keeping the core strong, navel to spine, let's start to exhale and lift the arm and leg off. Inhale, back down. Exhale, lifting it off. And inhale, back down. Now, this is not easy, okay? You're engaging the back of your leg. It's really easy to just slouch through the back and lift. I'm going to keep a nice tall posture and imagine reaching the arm and leg up and out. And inhale, back down. Good. Keep going. Inhale, back down. Keep that belly tight to the spine. Okay. And let's go for 4. Starting to warm up those legs. And 3. Notice if you start to lean to one side, bring it back into center. 2. And last one. Holding here. And all the way back down. Good. Let's switch sides. Keep those hips level to the floor. Just slide the right leg back this time. Left arm reaches forward. And let's exhale, lift it up. Inhale, back down. So this is really hard when you keep the core engaged and then you're just moving the leg and arm. If it's easy, you might be dipping into that low back. So make sure you're not doing this and arching the back. Just lift the leg and arm. Spine is long. And let's go for 4. Good. Remember to breathe. Exhale, 3. And 2. Good. Last one. And 1. Pausing there. And all the way back down. Very nice. Good. I want you to come down all the way onto your stomach now in the prone position. So I'll just wiggle myself forward, and you're just gonna stack your hands and rest your forehead down on your hands. Feet are hip distance apart, and reach the toes away from you. I say it all the time. On your next exhale, I want you to start to lift your right leg, and inhale back down. Exhale, lift your left leg, and inhale back down. Now you'll have your head resting on your hands, but just so I can talk to you, I'm lifting my neck. You want to relax your upper body as much as possible and just listen to me, I guess. And exhale, lift, inhale down, exhale, lift, inhale down. You want to feel that you're using the back of your legs and your glutes, not your low back. So you can see that my low back doesn't really dip, it's more the glutes that engage. Good. And from here, I want you to start to speed this up a little bit. So imagine that you're swimming on a flutter board. Let's start to pick it up. Reach those toes away from you, and I'll rest my head down now too. Keep breathing. You should really start to feel the back of the legs, the glutes, and the hamstrings. Good. Keep breathing, inhaling through the nose, and exhale through the mouth. Good. Really getting the heart rate up. Reach those toes away from you. Pull them back. Keep breathing. Glutes are engaged, squeezing the bum muscles. Really getting that heart rate up. And let's go for five. Kick really hard. Four and three. Two and one. Good. Rest all the way down. Whew. That really gets the heart rate going. Place your hands right under your shoulders and press yourself up and back. Good. Let's make our way into standing now. So just standing behind your mat. We're going to start to take the legs nice and wide now. So feet nice and wide, we're going to start to wake up those leg muscles a little bit more. On your next inhale, I want you to start to squat down. Exhale, pressing up. Good. Inhale, squatting straight down. And exhale, pressing up. Have a look down at your knees. Make sure they're not going over the toes. You don't want them turning in. Think about, wrapping out from the hip bones. Okay, not just the knees. So wrap those leg bones around and you're gonna feel a lot more through those bum muscles. Going straight down and straight up. Good. So I know it's hard to balance. Keep your weight in your heels. Keep that core engaged. And let's make it a little bigger. Inhale, reach the arms up and exhale down. Press into those heels. Inhale. And exhale, starting to really tone the inner thighs, the glutes. Inhale, reach, and exhale down. Press the weight right into those heels. Exhale. So this routine will really get you ready for Christmas. You're gonna feel really, really tight through the core, strong through the legs. You're gonna be looking good for that Christmas holiday. Inhale, and exhale. Make sure that the torso is going straight down. And let's go a little bit deeper. Three more times here. We're going to hold at the end. Three. And two. Exhale. Last time. And hold there. Just bring the arms down to the hips. Good. So you're in a nice low squat here. If you need to, make sure those knees are turning out. Leg bones wrapping back. On your next exhale, we're going to lift your right heel. Inhale down. Exhale, lift the left heel. Inhale down, make sure that chest is proud, you're not tipping forward. Exhale, inhale down. Now this is not easy, right? We're starting to feel the calf muscles, the inner thighs, and the core is keeping you really strong here. Exhale, inhale down. Let's start to speed it up. Good. Now this really gets the heart rate going. Really helping to boost that metabolism before that big turkey dinner. Let's go. Good. A little bit lower. Make sure you haven't come out of your squat like I just did. It burns. Inner thighs really engaged. Keep going. If you want more, bring your arms out into a T. Let's go. Reach those fingertips away. Standing up nice and tall. I can really feel this. I hope you can too. Good. And let's hold with that right heel lifted. Pulse your squat for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, really strong, 3, 2, oh my goodness, and 1. Place that right heel down, left heel lifts, and pulse for 10, 9, 8. Make sure that chest is still lifted. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Down, hold as low as you can and press all the way up. Oh my goodness.
Good. Heel toe your feet back in. Very nice. And let's just take the feet hip distance apart. We'll do a little quick cool down here. On your inhale, reach your arms up and reach up onto the toes and exhale back down. Inhale, reaching up, reach onto the toes and exhale back down. So you're going straight up and straight down. Imagine that you're reaching, reaching, reaching to get the star on top of the Christmas tree and back down. Good. Inhale up and exhale down. Keep going for three. And two. And last one, holding here. Bring your arms down by your sides. And I want you to start to tap your heels for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Good, release. Start to roll out your ankles. Take any final stretches that you may need. And other than that, you're all done. You can repeat this workout video as many times as you need to do. I hope you felt it as much as I did. Thanks so much for working out with me today. And don't forget to check out ftpilates.com. Thanks again. Bye.